I want to thank Nicario for welcoming us into his home, his gallery, and later his studio. And we start with a little bit of history, and family history especially. Nicario has explained this to us, and I want him to share so much how he learned this craft and some of the important both religious and spiritual dimensions of this. So we start by looking at work that was done by his grandfather. Nicario learned at the hands of his grandfather when things around. So tell us about a little bit about the artwork here that we see.
First, thank you for visiting my studio. Thank you, Rona. I know Rona, my best friend for many years. Thank you, Tony. Thank you, Annie, for visiting. First, I'm originally from a small village. It's called Alcamenca. If you see the map, you will not see it because it's a tiny village. Me and Flora, we grow up in a small village. It's different to all. We learn Spanish. I learned I was 40 years old, which is only we spoke Quechua. Quechua is Inca language. This is nice gift. This is nice learning. The culture, the art, everything in my village is different to all from the big city. Mm-hmm. Completely different. I know in my life this is more it's big movement. When I moved from tiny town to the city, when I moved to the city or to the big city, when I moved here, I was chopped back. In my village, I learned this technique, this kind of art. Before it's now called art. Now everybody tell them, you artist, you artisan. We lucky, I learned from people, for anthropologists, for historian art, I learned this kind of concept. Because why is, this piece is from my grandfather. I was lucky I have a few pieces. Yeah. This is called Cajon San Marcos, San Mark's box.
St. Mark's box.
Box.
Cajon San Marcos.
Cajon San Marcos is a cajon, is the box, because you see the box.
And these boxes were made from?
In my village is the high altitude, no trees, no wood. He using recycled wood. This piece, that is not using for decorations. This is more religious piece, magical religious piece. In my town, using two religions, the Andean religious, the Andean, the deities, and Catholic. It's mixed with the Catholic.
Yes.
But the Catholic influence. This box is always for 16th or 17th centuries. It's a portable, the carrying to go into village. It's in Quechua, it's called Misa Mastai. The offering the guy. Mm. Okay. This now using retablo. In big city in Huamanga, the capital, Huamanga is the capital from Ayacucho. We have 34 churches.
Mm.
34 churches, maybe more, okay? Using different sentences, it's called retablo.
Retablo.
It's a retablo, it's a Latin. Yeah, okay. It's mixed the two. It's the top, it's the Catholic, and in the road it's the Andeans from the Andes. This box is using for fertility animal, no using for decoration. Twice per year, August and February, because we have two seasons in the Andes, summer and winter.
Two growing seasons.
Uh-huh. Harvesting. I'm planting, men and woman, the sun and moon, day and night. That's it. Why is it true? This is the concept.
Okay.
It's Catholic sense is for different animals. St. Mark's is for cows, St. Luke's is for llamas, St. Anthony for donkeys. Not that big. One box, maybe my grandfather changed for a wet cow or wet chocolate. Yeah, wet donkey.
So the barter to get the box.
Yeah. This is the use these factors. 1968, my father moved to Syria, to Wamanga, from my village. Which is, the woman is very tourist town for Holy Week. Tourists, okay. Also, the retablo maker, the other person who is making business. Like my father is, oh, why don't I make it for tourists? Mm-hmm. My grandfather, he never make it this for tourists.
Right.
Only my father. My father changed. This is for me, for my father. The second generation. It's the same idea.
So it's the same thing, so that you have the Catholic influence here and the Andean culture there.
Uh-huh.
And the Catholic Church did this all over the world when they were moving around. They would use the local culture to teach the native population about their religion.
Exactly.
So you see that, but you see where the Catholic is on top.
Yes. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Yeah. Also, these spaces don't too big.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because
yeah.
Yeah. You see? Yes.
So
this is the yeah. This yeah. Also this is from my grandfather. This probably this boxing I have before nobody signed it. It's just different type of
when you signed it because they didn't think they were making art.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yes, I learned it from helping to my grandfather, to my father. I was helping. Okay, when you try, okay, I learned my Spanish in the city, I go to school, but it's always helping my family, my dad.
But when you went back to the village and told us that you were making the tablets for the tourists trade for Holy Week,
yeah.
The response was, you don't do that when you're growing up.
No, my grandfather, no, because it's more. Was it this magical religious box?
Yeah.
Yes, it's not for tourists.
Yeah. And you can see how your father began to even embellish on what your grandfather did.
Yeah, if you own it, this, who have it from my grandfather, kids? Always have it. Okay, I ask you. I make a new one for you, you give me the old one. Yeah, it's only one. If you ask it, oh, this is too old, put the how much is telling me? No. The people listen to this is no. This is very old, but okay. Oh yeah, I make a new one for you.
And we'll see that Nicario takes this again to multiple levels in many different ways.